So exactly how accurate is a better route planner when you use it to plan a trip with an electric vehicle? I saw a post on social media from an acquaintance of mine saying that he couldn't find any resources in vlogs or blogs or Reddits or anything about the chargers around his area, and so he was going to go out and do it himself for everybody else and take one for the team. I said, hey, get PlugShare. People are already doing that. You need to get on the PlugShare app and find that out. And for road trips, a better route planner is also what I recommend. And I recommend a better route planner for anyone who's number one, new to EVs, or number two, doesn't have a car like that Tesla back there that can plan the route for you within its own native software. That way, if you go into a better route planner, you'll at least know where those chargers are. You can notate their addresses. You can, with the premium subscription, you can navigate on a better route planner, or you can just write down the addresses and use Google Maps or Waze or whatever you want to do. Now, I promised on my last video that I would give you a comparison of how accurate a better route planner was to real life. We recently took a road trip to the Lake of the Ozarks State Park. I'm wearing the shirt for the theme. Hey, how about that? And I have some statistics that I would like to go over. When planning the trip, a better route planner estimated that we would need 193.6 kilowatt hours of electricity, that we would spend 2 hours and 37 minutes sitting at fast chargers, and that it would cost us $53.77 total for all of those charges. In reality, it was underestimating and overestimating depending on which one of those categories you looked at. Real life from the trip at just the chargers that it was planning for us to stop at, instead of 193.6 kilowatt hours, we actually needed 227. We needed more electricity than a better route planner had estimated. However, instead of spending 2 hours and 37 minutes at these fast chargers, we only spent 2 hours and 4 minutes. So it overestimated the amount of time that we would be stopped at the chargers. Here's the other side of it. We actually spent $84.07. So its cost estimate was way under. I'm going to go into each of these charge stops and kind of break it down. Our first charge stop was supposed to be at the Buc-ee's in North Fort Worth. A better route planner said we'd need 3.3 kilowatt hours. We actually took on 13. It said we'd need 10 minutes to charge, and that's exactly how long we were there, 10 minutes. But it estimated $1.03, and it actually cost $4.55. Our next charge stop was Ardmore, Oklahoma. It said we'd need 7.6 kilowatt hours. We took on 14. It said we'd be there for 10 minutes. We were only there for 7. It estimated a cost of $2.50. It actually cost $5.32. The next one was in Oklahoma City. Our estimate was 29.5 kilowatt hours. We took on 38. It estimated 22 minutes. We were actually there 26. So that one went the other direction. And instead of $9.74, it cost $14.44. On day two of our trip, we stopped to charge in Joplin, Missouri. We were supposed to take on 6.3 kilowatt hours. We took on 19. We were estimated to be there 10 minutes, and that's exactly how long we were there in real life. The cost estimate of $1.94 turned out to be $6.84. Then it was on to Springfield, Missouri, where we stopped at a Buc-ee's. The estimated charge amount was 12.2 kilowatt hours. In reality, that was 7. We were supposed to be there for 12 minutes. We were there for 3 minutes. Instead, and it was estimated to be $3.80. It was really $2.52. Now, for full transparency, I do not have the charging membership on this car. I messed up, and I should have done that for that road trip. For the road trip we've got coming up in late September, I will be doing that because that membership will pay for itself after the first couple of charges. And somebody's going to comment about that, and so there, I've said it. The return trip we did all in one shot. Our first charge stop was at Springfield, Missouri, at that same Buc-ee's. A better route planner said we'd need 5.3 kilowatt hours. We actually needed 20. It said be there for 10 minutes, and we were. It estimated $5. It was $7.20. onto Joplin, Missouri. It estimated us to need 12.2 kilowatt hours. We took on 23. It said we'd be there for 13 minutes. We were there for 12. And instead of $3.78 on its estimate, it was really $8.28. Then on to Catoosa, Oklahoma. It said we'd need 31.2 kilowatt hours. We actually took on 30, so those were very close. However, it said we'd be there for 24 minutes. We were only there for 17. It estimated $10.31 of cost. It was $11.40. So there, the cost was pretty close along with the kilowatt hours. You notice a theme here? When the kilowatt hours are close to the estimate, the cost is close to the estimate because all of these superchargers charge by the per kilowatt hour. On to Oklahoma City. It said 25.3 kilowatt hours needed. We actually took on 28. We were supposed to be there for 19 minutes. We were only there for 13. And instead of $8.35, it was $10.64. To Ardmore, Oklahoma. The estimate was 22.2 kilowatt hours. It was really 21. We were supposed to be there for 17 minutes. We were there for 10. And it was estimated $7.32. We paid $7.98. So there we took on a little bit less in terms of kilowatt hours from the estimate, and we paid just a little bit more. Finally, Fort Worth, Texas, 11.8 kilowatt hours estimated. We took on 14. It said we'd need 10 minutes to charge. We only took 6. I didn't get the exact estimate, but it cost us $4.90. Now, will the cost be more accurate if I pay for the Tesla charging membership? Maybe. However, I didn't have a better route. I didn't tell a better route planner about that membership at all. It was really lowballing the amount of energy that I'd need, and it was lowballing, and as a result, the cost wasn't matching. However, the time was way under. So if you're going to use a better route planner to plan your trip, which I highly recommend, bear in mind that you may actually get there a little faster, or you may have more time to yourself to choose to see sights or eat or something like that to get where you're going on time. But I wouldn't necessarily say it's going to be accurate enough to budget your trip off of that. Allow a little bit of a discrepancy. Don't expect it to be exactly down to the penny. It is an awesome tool. I can't recommend this tool enough. I will say that on this road trip, we did not encounter any full chargers. We had some that were more than half full, but there were always available stalls for us at these Tesla superchargers. The last road trip we took in our Bolt, I couldn't say that about the CCS chargers just because there weren't enough of the plugs there. So I didn't think that was worth a whole different video. You can catch the stats on the road trip video or just that last little bit. So if I can conclude, I'm still going to recommend a better route planner just like I always have been doing. I'm still going to use it to plan road trips ahead of time just like I always have been doing. However, I'm going to know that I need to pay for the charging membership. I need to know that the cost estimate may be low and I need to plan on a little bit more money. I also know that I might be able to shave a few minutes off of my arrival time or take a little bit more extra time at a couple of these charging stops to get dinner or something like that, or go off somewhere and get some pictures. It's pretty dang close. Over 1,400 miles of that road trip, it was off by around a half an hour on time. So it's pretty accurate. It's just not exactly precise, and taking a computer algorithm 2 weeks in advance and comparing it to the real world as it's happening isn't really a fair comparison anyway. My final conclusion is it's going to be close enough. So if you found this video informative, please give us a like, comment with your experiences with a better route planner or any other route planning app, or even with your Tesla navigation or anything. I do want to say that I wanted to go from Fort Worth through Oklahoma City to Tulsa, and a better route planner wanted me to do that, but the car wanted me to go through Denison, skip Oklahoma City straight to Tulsa, and my car can't really do that 200-mile stretch without a charge, because it's got some battery degradation and it is a base model rear-wheel drive. But subscribe for more content. We've got another road trip coming up late at the end of September, and we've got our 2-year review of our Chevy Bolt coming up in a couple of weeks. Thanks for watching.